Thank you for joining me for another edition of the Bob Sullivan Show. Today I have on with me Renee Tem, a model and former American Idol contestant. How are you doing today, Renee?
I'm doing okay.
That's good. So how's the weather over in Chicago today?
The weather is really nice over in Chicago. It's getting kind of hot.
Kind of hot?
It's kind of hot.
Is that just you or is that the weather?
Pardon me?
Is that just you or the weather?
Please. Nice meeting. No, it's the weather, really. It's just the weather. Just the weather.
So, tell me a little bit about modeling. How? Who do you model for, and what's your, how's it going so far?
Well, it's going really well. Recently, I've been shooting with, like, a couple of local photographers. I've shot with Mark Hauser, and I'm kind of, he's, like, the guy that did Cindy Crawford's first shot, so I had to shoot with him, and that was really a lot of fun. And it was quite an experience to get to see, like, the history of his studio and who he shot with, like, shooting Michael Jordan and the different celebrities and shooting with various companies throughout the entire country. Like, it's a really interesting experience in meeting him and finding out about his life and how it is for him being a photographer. That was, like, the coolest part about shooting with him. And I've also been picked to be a suicide girl, so that's kind of a really good experience for me also. And just finding out about suicide girls and just being able to link that with my interest in indie arts is a really interesting kind of experience, as you kind of find yourself within the arts community anyway. It's just an interesting experience to kind of, like, find yourself through suicide girls that way. But being selected was, like, yeah, it's really a good opportunity.
How did you decide to go into a modeling profession? Who told you that? Was it you that decided? Hey, I'm pretty hot. I got the looks to be able to handle being a model, or was it more of a did somebody scout you and find you?
I don't really feel myself, like, really hot. I never feel that way. So I'm kind of, like, shy about modeling. So basically a few people were like, why don't you come and shoot with me? And I was like, okay, that'll work. Like, some small photographers here in Chicago and some that have done, like, a lot of work in throughout Chicago and New York. And I just kind of agreed to it. And it was like, okay, just people that I had met because I've been working in film and television as well. People that I've met, like, working in film and television, singing in different bands around the city. And I was kind of nervous about it, but I said, okay, that'll work. I can do that.
Yeah.
So that's kind of how I got introduced into the whole modeling scene, because normally it's just playing instruments and singing just around the city, just kind of getting, like, my name out there. And to add modeling to that is a really nice deal.
What is Suicide Girls? Because on the outside, that doesn't sound like something it doesn't sound very good. What is it exactly?
It doesn't sound very good, but it's a very popular website and magazine, and they show various models that are involved in the indie arts community and the tattoo arts community, and it's really huge throughout the country. It's huge. And the name doesn't sound, like, so great when you think about it, but the women that you see there are incredibly beautiful women, talented women, lots of painters, artists, photographers, like, different types of women, all colors and sizes, and what they do is just kind of focus on the indie arts community in general, just the indie arts and getting out there and spreading the word about just different styles within indie art, different photographers, and what's going on with the beauty within the indie arts community, and just focusing on revolutionizing independent arts and revolutionizing beauty because of what we have as the standard of beauty. So now we have a new standard with Suicide Girls, where you have girls that are punk, that have lots of tattoos, that are doing various things throughout the community, and their beauty is very different, but, like, strikingly gorgeous. So that's kind of what Suicide Girls is about.
Where did you first hear about Suicide Girls? Was it just somebody approached you from them, or had you known about them for a while?
Well, being in the arts community, the independent arts community in Chicago, I heard about them to various venues where I performed and gone to see various visual art displays by artists I know in Chicago. And basically just groups of painters and people that I knew here that were interested in Suicide Girls. And I saw the website and I saw the magazine and kind of did a little bit of research on the following within the indie arts community and their presence throughout the entire country, and got really, really interested in to find out how big they are and how many countries they are, how many countries they are present in.
What's the best part of being a model? What's the biggest perk that you have right now that you didn't have before becoming a model?
Being able to meet more photographers and learn more about photography and just the industry in general. Being able to get nice products, of course, and being able to kind of spread your name throughout the entire country and world a little bit faster than you might, than I might have just performing here in Chicago. Those are the biggest perks.
Who is somebody that really motivated you to be the best, or has motivated you throughout this entire process? Because I assume that, I may be wrong on this, but I assume that models don't always get treated the best, or given there's a lot of put downs towards women. How do you keep your head up, and how do you, where do you get your motivation from when times are tough?
I receive a lot of motivation from my mother, surprisingly. She's not really so keen on me posing, like beginning to pose nude in some places, like for Suicide Girls, that's a nude shoot. Mm-hmm. She's not very like hip with that, but I get a lot of my motivation from her. And luckily, having experience in film and television, being an assistant director, a production assistant, script supervisor, different roles like that, I can kind of hold my head up high and know that I've been in the industry and have worked really hard to try to know what's going on, mm-hmm. instead of just going out there blindly and not knowing anything about the industry, what you're doing, about the makeup, the lights, anything. So that kind of helps with the whole attitude that models are treated certain ways. I don't really have to deal with that so much just because of the connections I've been able to make working behind the scenes and knowing a whole lot about the industry.
What was, when you first started posing nude, how much did that, how long did it take you to convince yourself to do that? And
the first time it was very easy just because I was doing it for a fine arts gallery, like a fine arts photographer, and it was something that was, it was semi-nude. It was very, very tasteful, covered up. Suicide Girls was very tasteful, and everything is fine with that, but it wasn't very hard just to have that mindset, like, of, not the mindset, but have, like, experience in the arts community, visual arts, like, knowing about nude posing and photographers and photography in general, and seeing that in art galleries and stuff. So it wasn't really very, very hard for me to do that. To do Suicide Girls, it's a little bit harder. It's a similar situation because it is definitely, like, tasteful and it's leaning more towards, like, finer arts.
Right.
But it's, like, fully nude, so I'm like, still, like, kind of getting over that, this part of it. Before, it wasn't so fully nude, and it was a little bit different. But for this, it's going to be, yeah, it's kind of big.
Who's the, have you had any ex-boyfriends or ex, any exes come back into the picture since you started doing this, or have they, has there been any people come out of the woodwork?
I don't really date that much. Yeah. Goodness, no, not really. I've been kind of taking my time and spending a lot of time alone, meditating a lot on, like, what I want to do and working toward that and meeting a lot of different people, and it's just been a whole lot of work. Mm. Other than that, I don't really date that much, so I haven't really had a lot of ex-boyfriends coming back around.
What would it take? What would get you, what would a guy have to do to get a date with you? What's the deal breaker, and what's the what would be a key to getting a date with Renee?
Just be real nice. I'm kind of into, like, indie nerdy guys right now.
Did you say indie nerdy?
Yeah, indie kind of nerdy guys, like, made glasses, stuff like that. Like, I'm into playing video games, too, so
ooh.
I kind of like video games a little bit. So kind of be one of those kind of guys and just like to chill out, and I don't like to rush anything, so just kind of take it easy and let me do my thing, you do your thing, you can get a date with me.
What about...
I haven't had a date in a long time, so yeah.
What about when it comes to, like as far as, how difficult would it be for you to date a guy that would have a, not a problem, but would be self-conscious about you in your modeling? Does that have to, would you ever give that up for dating a guy, or would you just continue doing it and it's kind of a... they have to learn to live with that.
Well, I've kind of thought about that, and this is something that's very important to me. This particular project is definitely very huge, and it's so well worth it to have that just on your performance resume. It's a beautiful experience. It's a beautiful company. And just to have that experience there is, like, well worth it. So I would definitely continue to do that. And it's not something that's gratuitous at all. So if you can't really deal with that, it's kind of like, well, I don't know. Because that's something I definitely want to do, and it leads to so many other opportunities, so many huge opportunities, different endorsements, different things like that. Like, you kind of got to go with that.
Now, when you're in these shoots, how many... Is there a rule that guys have to have their hands outside of their pants, or what's the rule on that? It's a creep-free zone, then.
Oh, yes. It is definitely a creep-free zone.
How much have you had ads on Facebook and Twitter and different social media sites because they've seen images of you? Or how many times do people comment or post on your Facebook just really creepy comments like, just like a random picture of you out on a Friday night, and they're like, oh, baby, I wish I was out with you or something. How often does that happen?
Not on Facebook or Twitter in my neighborhood, or in Chicago, I've seen a lot, and you can't do it.
What's the easiest part of modeling, and what is the most difficult part?
The easiest part of modeling would be for me knowing about production in general, knowing about the vehicles that I've seen, like, and knowing about, like, the kind of part that you want, and being able to take that, look at that, decide how you want to, and then how you want to put it back to the company. The hardest part, Tony, has been so hard for me. A little different, and like a lot easier with just pose. It's, I've been used to doing things and actually moving around a lot, you know, things and all those kinds of things. So posing has been like made the most difficult part. Other than that, no. It's not so hard, but you're trying to get used to like having just you and a photographer and a group of other people doing these kinds of poses, like the type of video we perform on stage, you know?
Right. Yeah, I get what you're saying. Do you, what's the most sexually suggestive song you sang at a club? and how many drunk guys were like, whoa, and like really got going.
I think the same, did I sing something that, I think I was in a band and we had like some original songs, like, and I was in a brother band, and what was I singing? I think Nikki Sweeting or somebody, I don't know.
Bootylicious?
Yeah, just a little bit of it, but just thank you. I'm like, no.
Is it, it wasn't Bootylicious, though?
No, it was not Bootylicious. No, it was,
Oh, okay.
I believe it was somebody said that.
What's the one song that you wouldn't want to ever sing in front of a group that you've almost had to bite the bullet and sing it, or you did have to bite the bullet and you were terrified to sing it?
Nothing. I love to sing.
Anything?
I was a little girl started singing classical music and opera.
What's your main expertise and what do you sound best in?
Oh, I think R&B would be best, and I'm kind of like a good you. So, sure, those two. And I'm going to play like what you mean by like, yeah, the competition, like, I'm mostly in R&B. It's like my focus. And what's the impact on you? Because I'm not supposed
to. What do you do to say? What do you do to stay in the, to be able to, like, you got to be able to look good, not only on stage, but you also have to have a good, like, you have the whole package, essentially. You got great voice, you got brains, because, I mean, you went to Notre Dame.
St. Mary's at Notre Dame, and I also went to Notre Dame, like, so I went to both.
Right, and, I mean, you're really smart, you're a model, you can sing. How have you been able to get all of that into one person? That's incredible.
There's more, so yeah.
Let's hear it. What else am I missing?
I've been, like I told you, I started off as a classical musician. I've been at Interlochen Arts Camp, and I've studied at the Chicago Sherwood Conservatory of Music in Chicago. I've been nominated for an NAACP Image Award at the University of Notre Dame. So that was also, like, a really huge accomplishment for myself. I'm also a playwright. I got nominated at St. Mary's Notre Dame for Extraordinary Student Achievement for theater performances and theater script writing, like, directing, things like that.
Okay.
So, like, basically those kind of things. And, like, who's who among college students and stuff like that. And just being able to work behind the scenes on many, many projects here and being able to work with, like, so many directors, like, yeah.
How is that humanly possible to, I mean, you've got it all, really. I mean, you got all the, all the talent, all the looks. I mean, what's the weak spot of, Renee? What's your guilty pleasure on the weekends? Do you like ice cream? You play, watch a movie? What's your guilty pleasure?
I like Italian bean tortillas in Chicago. That's a guilty pleasure. That's what I love to eat. I eat a lot of fattening food. A whole lot of fattening food.
Well, when I eat fattening food, I turn into a blob. not Bob, a blob. And how do you turn that fattening food into a beautiful woman?
I stay on the go a whole lot, and weight really hasn't been an issue for me. Like, ever since I was a kid, I kind of stay kind of skinny, about 100 pounds, 105 pounds, something like that, about 5'4". So I'm like kind of the same, like slim build.
What's the worst, like, I hate dieting. Dieting sucks. And
yeah.
I can't, like, my last go with dieting involved the first ever, I believe, Dr. Pepper diet. I'd replace a meal at lunch with a 52-ounce Dr. Pepper from QT. Maybe a hopeful sponsor in the future for the Bob Sullivan Show, but I'd replace lunch with that Dr. Pepper, and I ended up losing like 70 pounds strictly off of that. What's your key to dieting and staying sexy?
I do eat a lot of fatty foods, but I try to keep a lot of juices in my diet and a lot of water. That helps out a whole lot, to keep a nice healthy flow of juice and water coming into you. You might eat fatty foods, but make sure you getting a lot of juices and water, lots of fluids, and keep yourself running around, keep yourself busy.
When you're when you went to try out for American Idol, what was the most terrifying part of that?
None of it.
None of it?
None of it. I loved to perform. None of it was terrifying. It was I just want to make it. That was it.
Not even Simon Cowell. He didn't even.
No.
Not at all?
Not at all.
Did he say anything mean to you at all?
No. It was a nice experience, a very nice experience. And just being able to train with them for the time that you're in California, I stayed for the whole time. So I made it all the way through, pretty much all the way to the end. And yeah, the whole experience was very nice.
You weren't involved. You weren't in the. Were you in the one where Paul Abdul slept with one of the contestants?
No.
No.
I wasn't in that one.
So you got you didn't get screwed by, well, no pun intended. You didn't get screwed by Paul sleeping with one of the contestants. It was just who was the competition when you were around?
I think Ruben was there, and that's pretty much all I remember. And I ran into him again in Chicago a couple years later at a music seminar. I spoke with him, and he was doing really well. And I'm really happy to know that his career is taken off.
Ruben's,
I'm just glad that my career is taken off too, so I'm happy about that.
Ruben Studdard's career's taken off?
Yeah, he's done a whole lot over the past few years. He's had a few albums. He's been able to get himself to a place where he can do what he likes to do. What he truly enjoys doing, and that's the wonderful part about American Idol. If you can really get there, they put you in a position, if you can get to those places where you can really benefit from the networking opportunities that you have, and you can get yourself to a place where you can enjoy what you are doing and do it the way you like to do it.
Who is the biggest bitch or biggest jerk that you met along the way during the American Idol experience?
I didn't meet anybody that was really like that at all. Everybody was really supportive. The whole entire production community there was very supportive. Come on, Renee. You're doing really well. And there weren't any major setbacks at all. I had a lot of support when I was there. Unfortunately, I got right there to the last part and didn't make it. But after 20,000 people almost, to get to top 40, it's yeah. That's really decent.
What's the part of American Idol that you wish that you think they need to work on, or they needed to work on, that doesn't really, in my opinion, they don't always get the person who's best. Sometimes it comes out I don't know a bad example, but I think there's been times when the best hasn't always won. And that's because the fans vote. Do you think there's any tweaking they need to do to the American Idol system, or do you think it's fine the way it is?
No, I think it's perfect, exactly the way it is. The vocal training that you get when you're there is superb. You get a lot of training, and they let you know about the industry in many, many ways, and what you need to be prepared for, and how to keep yourself well, healthy, performing, and be able to get a nice social network out there should you not make it to a certain place within the American Idol system. So leaving there, for me, where I was at, taught me many, many things about just the industry and what I needed to do to get myself to a place where I can work after that, where it's not just that, and it's oh, no, nothing else,
Mm-hmm.
Well, there was nothing else they need to do.
What was the advice that you've taken to heart from that experience that has improved your music?
I wish you could have seen me then. Well, working on my image, like, wonderful voice. But I was kind of a nerd in college, you know?
Yeah.
Like, I was really a nerd in college, like, a little short, curly hair, like, a nerd. So it was, like, working on my image, and this is where it's gotten me to, like, being able to photograph, like, someone, like, with huge photographers and being able to do something that's really, like, huge throughout the country, such as posing for suicide drugs, weren't you prepared to do that? Like, so I think just I took that advice and went out and did what I had to do.
Do you think you're, I mean, you got a great personality, you are, like, drop-dead gorgeous, and how, as this is my theory. I mean, it's probably a shared theory amongst a lot of people. But my theory is that chicks who don't develop that, don't develop their personality, it's because they're hot right from the get-go. Like, guys think they're hot throughout high school and whatever, and so they have that, well, every guy's going to think I'm hot. I don't have to worry about this, that, and the other. And they don't develop a personality. They just rely on their looks. Now, like you said, I don't know if I can't confirm or deny this, but you said that you were a nerd in college. And did that allow you to develop all the other wonderful assets you have now that make you one of the best catches available right now?
Thank you. It made me definitely look. Having, like, all the experience in music and just in the creative arts community in general, and just those networking opportunities that I've had as a child helped out a lot, but kind of knowing that you got that funk thing going on and taking a look at that, like, and just being able to change that. I don't know, just being a nerd in college made me look, when I, like, got to American Idol and started looking at, like, myself and, like, looking at what I really want to do, is like, oh, girl, you need to, like, change these things. And to get that advice from them, like, in many ways, it was like, yeah, careful, like, you know, like, this is what you need to do. It was like, okay, so I gotta do this, and I guess I'm doing it. I don't feel like a hot chick yet.
Yeah.
But, you know.
Do you feel like you're a catch, though?
I just feel like working and keeping myself well and getting to where I gotta get to. It's not like whether or not I don't really feel hot yet. I haven't felt like hot yet. I gotta kind of get there with that. I definitely feel better about the image that's just like going out there to the people. I feel a lot better about it, but there's still things I want to work on, but I feel a whole lot better about, like, what's going on, and now I'm in a really good place. I'm feeling really hot. I don't know, I kind of got to get the whole hot thing moment, but feeling like I can do what needs to be done to, like, make myself happy and enjoy, like, what I love doing anyway, yeah, I'm there.
When was the first time you got hit on that, like, you said you haven't felt hot yet, but how much, like, I mean, I've hit on you a little bit here, but what's the main thing guys say to you when you go out in public, or what's a pickup line that you enjoyed?
Just basically, like, what's your name? Like, you sound really nice, like, where are you going to be performing next? That's the one I get. Where are you performing next? Like, we see, like, that one. I get that a lot. I was getting that a lot before I started modeling. Like, and now it's kind of like, are you real? I got that one. I've gotten that maybe, like, 10 times. Are you real? And I'm kind of like, what? I was thrown back. Like, what do you mean? I'm not real. So that was kind of like, it, like, I was kind of very excited about hearing that.
anything that really gets you a what's the worst thing anybody said to you that you just were like, okay, all right, go ahead and look the other way because I'm not going to look back your direction? Or have you had a moment like that?
It wasn't having a moment like that. Like, I haven't really had moments like that recently. Like, no. When I was in college, like, you might like a guy or whatever, and he wasn't really into you that much. And that was okay. Now I'm looking a little bit better, so it's a little bit different now. But that's what I could be about it. Like, just, you know, her feelings of being a little bit nerdy in college. That was about it. But now I don't really have to face that anymore. Mm-hmm. I haven't really had any negative comments at all.
Is there a negative comment that you ever think about that another person has said to you, or another, another performer has said to you that sticks in your mind that really that helps you, okay, I'm going to go work out today because she said I was fat, or she, do you ever have any things like that go through your head?
I think it's more personal. When I was beginning to like record with a group that's called The Basement, mm-hmm. It's a small record company here. It's with the independent arts community, and they do a lot here in Chicago, different performances at various venues here. Like, it's really big in the arts community. And going there and like not being satisfied with how I'm feeling, like, in the booth and stuff like that. Like, it's just a personal thing. You want to be your best. You want to, like, it's always going for improvement. You want to, like, do your best. Like, and if I'm not personally satisfied, it's kind of like, yeah. Nothing anybody else has really said. It's just more of myself, like, scrutinizing, personal scrutinization and, like, criticism, self-criticism, like, you know.
Are you harder than on yourself than anybody else is on you?
Yes.
What's the thing that you that you're hard on yourself about? That what's the thing that you're hardest on yourself about?
Having worked behind the scenes, it would be making sure the look is right, making sure the sound is right for the project that I'm working on. It has to be a certain way, very fine tuned, a very staunch way of performing and making sure that the look is a certain way. Like, I'm really serious about that.
What about in modeling? What is something you're hardest on yourself for in that area?
Basically, posing, I would say. Making sure that everything is proper and I'm feeling, like, really comfortable with what I'm doing, very loose and relaxed, and there's a lot of fluids flowing within myself, like, energy's working really well, and so I'm really hard on myself about, like, posing, and it's not like a practice, it's just kind of like a daily thing for me, like, just to make sure those things are, like, kind of straight as I think about, like, different projects I have to work on, like, making sure that, like, posing is not so much of an issue, because it's been an issue, so I'm kind of, like, getting a lot tougher on that, like, with myself, like, posing and making sure, like, you don't feel stiff on stage, things like that.
Is there a thing you're uncomfortable, is there any aspect of modeling that you're uncomfortable with, or have you all gotten completely used to everything, or is there something you're a little standoffish with right now?
I was kind of standoffish with the whole posing nude thing.
Right.
And as I prepared to do the suicide girl shoot, I'm still kind of nervous about that a little bit. I'm getting more used to it, definitely. But I'm still kind of like, a little bit like, I don't know. But to do it for that company, mm-hmm. is definitely well worth it. And I've posed nude in the past, so a couple of times, so it might not have been in the same setting. It might have been semi-nude, but I'm getting used to that.
Do you, is there a what was the modeling or a picture that you're really proud of that you really like? What's the standout pose that you've done? What's your go-to pose?
I don't think I really have one at the moment. I was really pleased with the, she said it was Martell's. I was very, very pleased with that. And he's, like, kind of helping me out, like, with being selected for Suicide Girls. And it's, like, really positive kind of vibe I get from him on that. So, and I look forward to shooting with him again.
Now, is, like, what's the one thing, like, I know, like, there's a lot of a kind of a like stereotype that, I mean, what's the stereotype that with girls that pose nude, what's the stereotype you've heard most, and how do you downplay, what's the one stereotype that doesn't apply to you for a model?
There is a stereotype that they'll be easy, in quotations, like, but with Suicide Girls, you definitely don't get that vibration from the whole situation. I think that just about with any of the models now that are definitely posing for Suicide Girls and within the indie arts community, nude or otherwise, you don't really get that so much at the moment, but that would be the only stereotype. And I think we're slowly but surely breaking that to let it be known, like, this is not that kind of situation. Like, it's so art-focused and not focused on sexuality in the like, I'll sleep with you kind of way, you know?
Right. I mean, it's tough to, I mean, it's tough to get that, like, I know, like, I understand the message, but it I mean, it's, like, it's tough to understand a message with, like, PETA or something when, like, Jessica Alba's, like, butt naked on a, like, with a, like, a cheetah skin covering, or not even cheetah skin, like, some, like, no animal skin on her or something. I mean, it's tough to really get the message, but how do they relay the message to you, or do you always get, before modeling, do you understand the product before modeling for it?
Yes. There's an understanding of what I'm doing, like, what concept they have, what concept they have in mind, like, what they've done, what the artist has done in the past, and how they want to move with that. Mm-hmm. And you have to do, like, a little bit of research on the photographer that you're photographing for. Mostly it's been, like, you know, like, gallery photographers, different things like that I've been posing for. So that's kind of what it's been, like, recently.
I have a couple more questions before I let you go. What is a spindly white, not very athletic, kind of like guy with a shaved head like me have to do to get a date with a model such as yourself?
Be a nice boy. Be a nice guy.
Be a nice guy.
Yes, be a nice guy.
Do I portray that characteristic?
Yes, definitely.
Really?
Yes.
What else is a key to my my charm? Or do I have charm?
Yes, you definitely have charm. I'm just really, like, excited about the show and just happy to hear about young people that are stepping out there and putting their best foot forward and starting their own television shows, their own websites, their own small businesses, and things of that nature. So I'm really proud of you in that regard. Like, to be a young artist out there doing that is really remarkable.
Well, that is a huge turn on for me that you referred to me as an artist, because I've never been referred to as that before. That is a huge, that is something that I've never been called, so I appreciate that. Do you want to put in a tune, or do you want to sing a song before we go?
No, not on the phone.
Not on the phone?
My phone is terrible right now. It's like all static.
Not even a... You don't want to sing the first ever Bob Sullivan Show song?
No, I just don't think. My phone is terrible at the moment.
Okay. Is there anything else you want to pitch before we get going then?
Not particularly. Just look out for me in the Suicide Girls website. And hopefully Ruckus Magazine coming up. I've like made submissions to them, so hopefully you'll be seeing me there also. But definitely you should be seeing me within Suicide Girls site within the next like 6 weeks, I believe.
Okay, cool.
So you should be seeing that. And I just want you to just keep it rocking, and I'm just glad to have been on your show.
Oh yeah, it was a lot of fun. We have to do this again, and I got to get better prepared because now I know some more avenues to go down to discuss with you. We'll have to break down some celebrities, or we have to. I have some fake reality show pitches that I might have to give to you.
Okay.
So. Well, Renee, it was a lot of fun having you on, and good luck with Suicide Girls, and I wish you luck in your music career as it is ongoing, and I look forward to doing this again.
All right, so it was nice talking to you, Bob.
Yep, nice talking to you, too. Thank you for listening to that edition of the Bob Sullivan Show. Check out any episodes you may have missed on the Bob Sullivan Show page.